forgot to mute the stream. There we go. Fucking hell!
So we're good now?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So you...
Yeah.
Introduce yourself, I guess.
Okay, yeah. So let's start at the beginning. So this is Squall, the editor-in-chief.
I'm already angry at the game. Sorry.
This is, we are from MyGamer.com, and you are?
I'm Gillman from MyGamer.com, and I'm super angry at this game already, and I've been playing it for, like, I'm going to say maybe 10 minutes.
Yeah, so this is, and Gilman's the one playing here.
I'm almost always the one playing.
This, you pretty much always are the one playing.
Occasionally Grizz will jump on.
So this is AirRace Speed, and this is actually the Vita version, which are streaming right now through the PlayStation TV. However, it's the same game. It's basically just a port, but this game first originally came out on 3DS on the eShop. Maybe it's on Steam? I don't know that. One of the whole gimmicks when it first came out on the 3DS eShop was this game actually looks pretty good in 3D because you're racing down this tunnel. The whole point of this game is to actually just get a faster score, so you can just boost. It's been a while since I played this, I reviewed it for the site, but our MyGamer is actually currently down. We're actually switching servers right now, so we apologize for that. Otherwise, I'd go back and read my own review to remember what the hell I wrote and played about this game. But you're not racing against other people.
It's just
It's all time trial. Now there are some like shortcuts and stuff if you look hard enough for it. You know, there's some harder turns to take, but it might shave just a second off your time. But this game, a second off your time could be a lot. Because this game's all about just getting a faster, better speed run. So you can see here that you're going really fast. It's kind of like, almost think of like F-Zero, but without other players, and you fly instead of being solely restricted to the ground.
Like the F-Zero for the GameCube.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like you could just watch the stream here. It's brightly colored. It's you can pick from you can get a few different vehicles. And they came out with, on 3DS, there was a sequel. So there was AirRace Speed, and then there was AirRace Xeno, which was basically the same game, just kind of like more tracks. But this game is only, I think it's only $5. Like, it's even on the eShop, it's $5. Yep, no, wait, you gotta go, I remember this track. You gotta make a big doo-doo there. Yeah.
So
when you crash, it tells like you can start, there's pretty good checkpoints, but obviously you have to restart and you get a penalty, a time penalty. So you can keep going if you want, and it tells you exactly how much progress in real time in the upper corner. Until you have to go to finish. Some tracks loop, like you have to do laps, but then I want to say there's like maybe a couple tracks where it's just like one giant long track instead of just doing three laps or just going through one big track, basically.
I already hate this level very much.
Yeah, it's one of those things where because it's so built on time and you're essentially just racing against yourself, you really got to nail down the memorization of each track, as opposed to let's just say Mario Kart. Like Mario Kart has the random element of,
why can't I hit this?
See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Like, it gets kind of addicting.
It's not addicting.
I like this game on 3DS. Again, it was only a few bucks, and you gotta find the right vehicle.
I need to like invert the analog.
That's obviously, I'm an inverter myself. Yeah, there you go.
Well, I'm flying is the thing.
Yeah, and I believe, oh man, I wish our site wasn't down right now. that you can use motion controls even if you wanted to as well.
You can on this. That was the first...
Okay, all right.
That was the first fucking thing it asked. It's like, do you want to turn on motion controls? And I'm like, considering this is the Vita TV, no, I don't.
Yeah. I mean, when I reviewed it on the 3DS, I played it and it worked better than I thought it was. It wasn't too bad, but I still prefer the old analog stick control. Yeah, and then you get graded. You get your stars. So you got the silver star.
This is I don't know what Nitro is. I haven't like.
Oh, yeah. You get like the boost, like because I think the control is just basically just like accelerate, like, and that's it, right? Maybe there's a brake, but then I think there's Nitro, which is like the super boost.
Yeah, I'm like hitting buttons and not paying attention.
Yeah, that'll do it.
There's like a bank button, like I can.
Bank. Oh, you can turn, can't you? You can rotate your Is that the shoulder buttons?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's kind of like Star Fox in a way, but just no shooting.
You
go through tunnels like that, and it's like you go so fast, you don't know, is that a wall? Is that a light? You know, is that a curve? And you just kind of sometimes have to hope for you got to hope for the best.
Well, that's the thing that I really kind of already hate about this game, is that, sure, if you're playing this game, and it was like, for some reason, every other game on my Vita was deleted, and I had to play this on like a fuck you. That was a fuck you moment. Like, there was nothing I could have done to predict or avoid that movement, because it was just seemed to be like random. Like, I lost every game on my Vita, and I'm stuck on this long plane ride. Like, I can see maybe really getting into this. But aside from that, this game is kind of shit.
It's weird because it's only you racing. There's no other... You don't even play against ghosts. Like, you can't download ghost data or anything.
Well, it's not even... Yeah, and it doesn't seem like there's leaderboards.
Yeah, I don't believe there is. So I think it's all local. So
you don't even know if you're doing well?
So it's definitely... restricted, absolutely, in that, but at the same time, that's why the game is $4 or $5 or whatever. Is it $3.99?
$4.99? I don't know. It doesn't matter, though, because leaderboards aren't a difficult thing to add.
Yeah, it would be nice to have these features, no question about it.
Is there local multiplayer?
No. Nope, not that unless they added something for the Vita version, but I'm pretty sure there is not. So it's just single player only.
So there's no redeeming qualities at all about this game.
Let's see if I can find the here we go. AirRace Speed is a solo time trial racing game where you pilot the most powerful futuristic jets through adrenaline-fueled challenging tracks. Compete with your friend through online... Oh, there is online rankings. And get to the top of the rankings. Stunning tracks full of obstacles and shortcuts, simple controls, nine high-speed jets powered with advanced technology, epic graphics, top-notch soundtrack. So there's three modes to play. So there's time trial, there's endless, and then there's rings.
You know what this reminds me of?
And there are leaderboards. What's that?
Like a PlayStation 1 game.
Oh, it's $4.99.
Man, it's still too expensive. A PlayStation, like an early PlayStation 1 game that
like Project Wormhole
or something, like something along those lines that you would play and just be like, this is great, this game is so amazing, like, you know, like akin to what, like, somebody saw Wipeout and was like, we can one-up Wipeout, and like missed everything important about Wipeout, and you know, like, the sequel came out and was way better, but no one bought it because everyone hated this.
Yeah, I think fans too, you know, are, we haven't had a new F-Zero in a long time. We really haven't had a, we haven't had a Wipeout in a while. I mean, there was one on, like, I think there was one on PlayStation 3. Maybe that was like the next one.
That company went, Sony closed that company.
Yeah, so we haven't had a white, we haven't had a solid, like, futuristic racer like this in years. So this is like the first game of its kind, I believe. You know, maybe there's like Steam games or something that I'm just not aware of. But
oh, there are.
You know,
Wipeout,
so
Wipeout gets like not fun really quick, though.
I was never a fan of Wipeout. I never. It was never for me. I don't know. I've played a few of them, and I don't know. It just hasn't. The hook wasn't there for me.
Like, I played the first white. I played a couple Wipeouts on fucking. This thing controls like.
It's pretty. You got to get used to it. It's like slightly floaty. Yeah.
Dude, it controls like I'm slapping a hooker's ass while trying to drive a car. I don't know where that analogy was supposed to be going, but. It's kind of just like I'm doing one thing and hoping another happens. Like,
you gotta get used to it. Yeah, that's for sure.
I shouldn't have to. If you have to describe a game's controls as, well, you're gonna need to get used to them. Well, maybe you fucked up there. And like. There's no reason to go back to a car once you, unless like they start balancing out higher end cars, but it seems like there's no reason to go back to older cars once you've unlocked a new one.
Yeah, I wish I could go back to my review. I couldn't tell the big difference between all the different cars, the different ships, vehicles, whatever the hell you want to call them. You know, one would have better turning, one would be faster. They all kind of seem the same to me. There wasn't like a
drunk
big
monkeys
like,
in a fucking shopping cart.
Like, oh, this one's definitely is faster, and this one definitely has more responsive control. I never really got that. They all seem pretty much the same to me. I mean, when you're going this fast, I mean, everything is going to be
like jelly in a mudslide.
Like, yeah, like, I mean, you're scraping the ceiling here. I mean, if you're going to be doing that anyway, no matter which vehicle you choose, especially if you're boosting as fast as you can.
Shit's happening. I'll take your word that this one's better than the other one.
Yeah, well, this, I think. It's nice that this game is in, like, this, to see it in like, you know, it's not, you know, true super high definition, but it's still, you know, on the Vita, we're playing it on the PSTV. But I think it was one of the few eShop games, especially when it was on, you know, when it's still on 3DS, that you want to actually use the 3D slider for.
Oh.
Because you're going down a tunnel, and I actually think that it actually helped. You get these quick twitch turns, and like I said earlier, like, is that a hole? Is that an obstacle? What is that? It's coming so fast. But if you have the 3D slider on, you can kind of tell, oh wait, that is a wall, that is an obstacle. You can tell that a little bit better.
See this right here, the big open area, that feels cool.
It is mostly indoor. You get those brief moments of outdoor. And I think they have to do that because otherwise, I think it'd just be too easy to get lost. Like, where am I supposed to go? You know, you got to.
But if it was like an
design.
Open racer like that.
Oh yeah. I think this is like the first like now that they like nailed down their engine and they kind of have this game built and they know what's going on. Now, if they can just tweak it to add, you know,
good four and fun to, mechanics.
Four to eight player multiplayer, and, you know, you add some missiles and stuff in there, like, you might have a
little something. Add a game at any point.
Yeah, just it's going to be, I mean, there's going
to
be the limited appeal.
To make it fun in any regard.
Only going back and forth and, like, basically just doing time trial over and over and over, you're not going to be playing this game for hours on end.
No, you're going to do the bare minimum to unlock everything, maybe.
And then call it a day.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there's definitely limited replay.
And then be like, yep, I certainly fucking played that game.
Yeah.
Review done.
Yeah.
So, I need to bitch about something.
Uh-oh.
Nintendo needs to fucking fix their eShop and how it works. Because recently there was this big thing on the 3DS eShop that they're like, hey, we released the Mega Man X games from Super Nintendo on the eShop. And I'm like, oh, that's awesome, because...
Yeah.
I bought those on the Wii U, so I should own them on the 3DS.
Nope.
Nope.
Nope. There is no cross... there's only a... Yeah, there's only a handful of games, and it's up to, if I'm not mistaken, the publisher. It's not really... Well, Nintendo has to be on board to allow it. Or to code it, maybe, rather, is a better way to... But... Yeah, there's only a handful of games that support, if I bought it on Wii U,
Better example, I bought Earthbound on the Wii U.
That's a $12 game, $11 game or something.
And it's published by Nintendo.
Yeah, that game has the Earthbound tax on it.
Oh, yeah, well, no, it's basically just a niche tax at this point.
Yeah.
Like, it's a, well, this game is, like, a cult classic, and if you want to buy a fucking physical copy, go ahead and mortgage your house.
Right. It's still way cheaper than, you know, buying a Super Nintendo with a copy of it on eBay. But yeah, there's no cross-compatibility, cross-buy
systems. How is that acceptable in this day and age?
Yeah, and what has a lot of people worried now, too, is, like, when the Switch comes out, you know, if Nintendo's going to be like, sorry, all the games that you previously bought, yeah, you cannot play them on Switch. Or, like, what they did some kind of a...
You had to pay to upgrade on the...
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what... You had to pay, like, what, $1 or $2 to, like...
HD upgrade is what they called it.
The reason why they worded it like, oh, because now these games have Miiverse support, which nobody gives a shit about. And so now you're paying for, like, yeah, to play it on your Wii U and your off-screen TV play, and you're paying for stupid Miiverse compatibility, which, again, nobody gives a shit about.
Yeah. I'm actually, like, deeply fucking concerned, because on my Wii U... When I got my Wii U, there was, like, after the year of Luigi, there was, like, this time that I'm like, I actually really fucking like my Wii U. Like, there was, like, this really fucking solid year of Wii U games coming out.
Yeah.
Between, like, Splatoon and, Smash...
Mario Maker.
No, Mario Maker, I think, kind of fell outside of it, but it was.
Oh,
like,
yeah, that was a. Yeah. But there's.
But it
I
was
mean,
like
oh,
Smash Brothers came out.
Yeah.
Mario Kart came out.
Yeah.
And this
is
all within, like, 1 year, and it's like, new Super Mario World.
Yeah. Which is a good game.
U came out. It's like. All these, like, amazing fucking games all came out within a year. It was something crazy. Like, 5 amazing first-party games came out within a year of each other.
Yeah, there was, like, Pikmin, there was, you know, Zelda, Wind Waker, and stuff, HD, and... I mean, a lot of, like, all the Nintendo first-party stuff is usually pretty fucking good.
Well, you know, so but it was like the reason that you wanted to fucking buy a Wii was, I think it was like 2014. Mm-hmm. I want to say, like, whatever the year of Luigi, like right around then or like right after then.
Yeah.
And it was pretty fucking, like, that entire just, it was like, wow, I really like my Wii U. Maybe Nintendo is like gonna make a go out of this. And, like, had all this confidence in Nintendo and was just like, well, fuck it. They're releasing all these virtual console games, too. Awesome! Because tracking these down and, like, you know, I was getting into streaming, too, and I'm like, playing these on a stream might be fun. And so I'm just going to purchase them here, and, you know, for stream. And
yeah.
Like, I have shit that I'm, like, sitting there and I'm, like, looking at and I'm like, I want to... I have, like, all Metroids, for instance.
Yeah.
Like, all of them. Purchased on my Wii U.
Yep.
And I'm, like, sitting there and looking at them, and I'm like, yeah, those, the Super Nintendo and the Game Boy Advance ones, are they gonna make me buy those again on the Switch?
That's one of my big questions that I, you know,
because I mean, that alone is it, like, if I had to buy those again, that's like $40 fucking dollars.
Oh, I mean, if you can buy, I bought Metroid Prime Trilogy, you know, that was $20 or whatever it is. I mean, so that's the big question. I mean, no, they haven't released any Switch information yet,
you know, which is there, it's this month, right?
It's actually, man, is it next week, like Friday or something like that? They were going to have a Nintendo Direct about it or something.
It's the price. We know the release date is March.
They're saying March. Is it going to be price? I'm hoping they say like how much, you know, memory it has. Is it going to be bundled with the game? What games are going to be available at launch? You know, how long is the battery life? You know, what do you need to plug it into the TV, and like exactly how does it work? You know, I have a lot of these questions. The rumor was, you know, there's going to be GameCube backwards compatibility virtual console.
That thing that was supposed to be fucking part of the, like, they were going to start selling GameCube games on the fucking Wii U, and that never panned out?
Exactly. I think they might have been saving it. And then there's, you know, the big other rumor is that, you know, there's going to be like a Smash Brothers Switch port, which will have all the DLC, and that's when they'll launch the other, the two other amiibo, or the three other amiibos that haven't been made yet for Smash Brothers, and I'm excited about the Switch, but I still have all these questions, and I'm really looking forward to this, the stream.
I felt like an idiot, but I realized that I was like thinking about the Switch the other day, and I'm like, it's Nintendo, and it's realistically probably going to be like $250.
I was going to say $250, $249.99, and
like, if it's $300, I would be honestly shocked. I was thinking about it, and I'm like, I'm probably just going to fucking pre-order it and get it the day it comes out.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm just going to be disappointed with it, and I'm not even going to have it hooked up.
It'll be like, you know, $249, and then if you want, you know, then they'll do something like, okay, you want to spend $300 and get it with, like, you know, a Mario Kart 8 port already, like, built into the hard drive or something, you know, like something like, or like Smash Brothers will be included, or, you know, whatever the case may be, but they might do a bundle, who knows.
I think Nintendo thinks their shit doesn't stink right now.
That's the mentality they've had always, you know. So let's we'll see. This is gonna be interesting.
I'm scared because I don't know, like, I've been just like, so like one of the YouTube channels I subscribe to, I was just like kind of reading this like crazy things Miyamoto has done in the past, and it was basically like destroyed all strong relationships they had on the fuck, like,
going, yeah, with third parties.
Third party relationships going from the Super Nintendo into the N64.
Yeah.
Like, just destroyed them.
I mean, Nintendo's always been just, if you want the best first party games, you are going to absolutely play a Nintendo game, no question about it. You're pretty much always, like I said, always going to get a good time. But to have third-party publishers make quality games on a Nintendo system, at least in the last, since the Wii and even GameCube, I mean, it's been pretty rare. You know, the third-party support has been nothing like Xbox and PlayStation.
Well, supposedly, Star Fox 64 was mostly lifted assets from a canceled Star Fox game.
Well, Star Fox, well, they were making Star Fox 2 on the Super Nintendo.
Star Fox 2 was completed.
It was done, yes. And they never really they never released it because by that time, the N64 was out. And it's like, why would anybody
buy the Super Nintendo? The N64 wasn't out.
It was gonna be, but
no. That's the like for public consumption release. But if you look at the dates, the game was ready to be released and go out over a year and a half before the N64. Was out.
Yeah, they just never. I mean, Miyamoto was like, "Yeah, we, you know, a lot of the ideas that we took from the Super Nintendo version, you know, we put into the N64 game." And
here's the thing, though.
And even with
the
latest,
they didn't make the Super Nintendo version. It was a third party developer that never got paid for any of that.
Oh.
They took all of the assets, fired the developer. And then just like, yeah, we made this.
Huh.
Yeah, how fucked up is that?
My concern is like, what if the Switch fails? Like, what is Nintendo gonna do? You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, because the Wii U wasn't super successful.
Yeah, I mean, are they just gonna make, you know, continue to make 3DS games? Are they gonna really, you know, look at iPhone as a platform? You know what? So, I mean, because the Wii U didn't do great, you know, what if the Switch doesn't do great either? It's like, what kind of future is that going to be?
And then you get into the Nintendo saying that this is not supposed to replace the 3DS.
The 3DS,
and it's like,
it's
totally going to replace the 3DS. Like, you guys have every intention of this being a 3DS replacement. You have every intention of this replacing the 3DS.
Because the 3DS came out in, 2011? I mean, either way, it's been out for many years now, which is why they came out with the new 3DS version.
I like my 3DS, but the thing is,
they
said, and it's like, I was thinking about it, and I'm like, you guys said that about the 3DS when it came out with the DS. You said the 3DS.
Well, they said that when it was still the Game Boy Advance and the DS came out. They're like, yeah, we're going to have these two platforms, and then the GBA just died. You know,
oh, yeah, they're like, the DS is not meant to replace the Game Boy Advance. And it's like, why does it have a Game Boy Advance slot?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well, that's because it's not meant to replace it. PC, we're still supporting it. And it's like, clearly you're not. Is that why all these tracks suck? Because they're fucking...
Yeah, and I think like track 3 or something, or tier 3 was like the same tracks, but they're just mirrored or something like that. I want to say like some of the tracks, like they're just reused, and instead of turning right, you would turn left. Like they just kind of reused.
That sounds fucking terrible.
Yeah. Maybe I'm wrong. I mean, I gotta go back and read my own shit again, but...
Yeah, that was dumb. Not a great game.
It's not a, you know, no, it's not a great game, but at the, I don't think it's a bad game.
The one thing I'm excited for, they're making me redo this because I didn't fucking play it well enough. The one thing I'm excited for with the Switch is if it plays 3DS games. If they're really like, it's not going to replace the 3DS. By the way, it plays 3DS games.
I don't know. I don't foresee them doing that.
Why?
Well,
it's their new
sure,
fucking handheld.
But I'm sure they still want people to buy 3DS cartridges and download games on their 3DS. I mean, I'm sure they still want both platforms, at least now.
I think that's what they're getting at, is that this is the new thing.
I guess we will wait and see. Yeah, I'm looking forward to that Nintendo Direct that they're going to put out, because the world wants to know, and I want to know, damn it.
Yeah, I want to know, too. I would like to know.
One thing that I'm really... is the fucking thing better have enough storage space. I'm so sick, like... consoles now is like 500 gig hard drive. 500 gigs isn't going to get you shit. Like, I don't want to worry. Like, the last thing I want to worry about is storage space. Even the Wii U, like I said, I bought Metroid Prime Trilogy, takes up my entire hard drive.
Oh, yeah.
Like it's like, cut it. Like, I want to just be able to buy a significant amount of games and not even have to, like, worry about it.
Yeah, I would. I mean. Well, here, that's one of the reasons that I'm thinking about, like, with the way that Nintendo's doing shit, I'm like, I kind of don't want to buy digital games anymore. Because, like, they're freaking me out.
And Nintendo, the other thing is if you, like, lose your, like, your license, or if you try to switch consoles, like, it's a pain in the ass to, like, move all your shit over. Like, even if you had, like, if you're just taking your SD card out and you put in a new system, like, you can't, you know, like, and you got to go through this, like, 18-step process that takes forever. Like, that's, they
well,
need to work on
and
that
like,
too.
And, like, what happens if your console's lost or stolen?
Exactly.
Like, they don't care.
Like, Xbox, like, if you got to get a new console, like, you know, a whole new hard drive, you just sign into your Xbox account. Yeah, you got to re-download everything, but it's like right there. You don't have to like jump through hoops.
At that point, if you're bitching about re-downloading stuff.
Exactly.
Nintendo's so fucking backwards in the way things work.
I also want some kind of uniform. I'm not saying, you know, give me an Xbox Live platform. I know that takes a lot of work to maintain. And,
no, give us a PSN or
yes.
Xbox Live platform.
I want something. Yeah, I'm like, okay, the friend codes, like, okay, enough's enough already. Cut it out. Like, let's make a somewhat decent, usable, like, fuck Miiverse. Nobody cares about that. It doesn't even make sense.
No. It's like, yeah, Sony tried it. It was called Home. It failed.
It was horrible. That was the biggest joke ever. That was such a piece of garbage. I couldn't delete that from my hard drive fast enough.
Remember when they made you have it on your hard drive for a little bit?
Had it, yeah, you had it. Yes, I do remember that. And then they just like, yeah, we're going to just get rid of this. We kind of messed up here. And I remember, like, because I had the 80 gig Metal Gear, limited edition Metal Gear 4 PS3. So I only had 80 gigs, and like the stupid fucking Home took up like 8 or 9 gigs, which at the time was like a retarded amount of space, especially if you only have an 80 gig. And I was like, this thing has taken up like a ton of my hard drive space. Like, cut it out already.
Yeah. You've always been one to watch your hard drive space. You've always bitched about that.
Hate that so much. Especially us, because, you know, we get games for review. Like, you know, I want to go back and, like, play this game if the sequel comes out. Like, I don't want, like, it's just, I want to have all
do you
this
have
stuff.
Know how many games I have for review that I just end up deleting after I'm done with?
I have to do the same thing, yeah, because limited space.
I'm not doing a written review for this.
You're not gonna. You don't write reviews anyway.
I do written reviews. Like very Yakuza rarely. Will get one.
Yeah, Yakuza. Yes. Yeah, we'll stream that next one.
Hatsune Miku will probably only get a written review.
Yeah, there's a lot of. Even if we did stream it, like, or we post on YouTube, it like YouTube would block it.
It's not YouTube that'll block it. It's I'll actually get a strike, which is worse than a block. I'll get a fucking offense. Yeah. Like that shit's serious.
Yeah.
That's right. Sega's really cool about saying in social media, like they're like, no, you could totally say you're reviewing this game. It's fine. I'm reviewing Hatsune Miku and the new Yakuza.
Did you download it yet?
What, Hatsune Miku?
Yakuza.
No, I'm working on Miku.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, because we'll do that next week. That'll be a good game to check, because the embargo for streaming is lifted next week Wednesday, so that'll work out.
Miku is, the embargo's up on the 9th, so...
Ah, okay.
And I love the Yakuza games. They're just fucking... really fucking good. Can't even fucking describe them. They're just open world fun.
Yeah, we've gotten the last couple of them. I know we got, what was it? What was the last four? Which was
five?
Or five? Was it? Because it was originally that game.
The fuck just happened there?
That game came out in Japan like what 4 years ago?
Yeah, they weren't planning. They weren't planning on releasing it, and I guess it was just like a passion project of one of the localizers that was like, no, release this fucking game.
Yeah.
I own all of the Yakuza games. They're amazing. And they're as long as you want them to be, for the most part. I mean, they even talk, it's funny because like, in the letter, when they're talking about the embargo, they're like, you know, you guys are gonna fucking sit there and say, oh, I can rush through this and get this review done in like 20 hours, but don't you like, you know, the main story is 20 hours.
Yes.
And it's like,
yes,
absolutely, the main story is 20 hours. That is not the fucking point of a Yakuza game.
Oh yeah, that game, you know.
And not only that, but like
way longer.
Well, it's not only that about a Yakuza game. There's tons of side missions.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
There are side stories that are, I don't know about this one. Like I said, I haven't started playing it. There are side stories that are arguably almost as in-depth in some of the later ones as the main story. That you can get as involved as you want.
Yeah. I'm not thinking this is gonna. That it's not gonna be a short game.
But it's the Yakuza games are just. They're Japanese crime drama when it comes down to it.
So I'm assuming this is just me because I'm a dumbass and I haven't played any of them. But Yakuza Zero, this is like the very first game in the whole series. I didn't know that the games like continue on.
It's a prequel.
Okay.
It's so they kind
so it's supposed of to, it's supposed to take place in the 80s.
Before the first one.
In Tokyo in the 80s.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the Yakuza games sort of follow one guy. But there's like multiple characters that become important throughout, and like multiple ones that are playable characters, it's really good. It's sort of like any long-running franchise that it's like, you know, oh, well, we started off focusing on this one guy, and then, you know, as it went on, we you know, this guy developed more and more, and now he's the main character, too, and he's just as important as this guy. It's, you know, it's really fucking good. And, you know, there's even, like, the silly spin-off, like, Yakuza Zombie.
Yeah, I'm glad you're covering it because you've played all the rest of them, so you have the knowledge and you know what's going on.
What's going on here? Game froze.
Okay.
Always a sign. Call it.
So that's been AirRace Speed on the Vita. It's also available on the 3DS. It's like $5. It's
fuck
a single
it,
player only. Gillman says don't buy it. I don't think it's that bad. I don't think it's a fantastic game, but I don't hate the game either.
I think it's a steaming pile of dog shit. Don't buy it.
Currently MyGamer.com, the site we write for, is down because we are switching servers. Hopefully by the time we post this on YouTube or whatever, it'll be back up. We got a few kinks to iron out. We're trying to make the site go faster with loading times and things, which is why we're moving it. But we're running into some errors right now. But
if you had a choice between buying this game and having to lose a finger, go ahead and buy this game.
Okay, good. That's a good comparison. So it's not the worst thing in the world. Where can they find you, sir?
MyGamer. This will be posted on the YouTube channel, which you're probably watching this on, let's be honest.
Yeah. And I am, you could follow me on MyGamer.com as well. We post reviews, news, all that good stuff.
My year in review's up on it.
Yep. Gillman just posted his year in review. I think everybody, or Adam didn't post his yet.
Yeah, he did.
I did post Adam's. Yeah. And Oscar's actually just got recently posted too. So you could check those out. And then next week we will be back streaming most likely Yakuza 0, just like we said. So until then, thanks for watching and game on.